But we know our spirit is in the right place, and we do that in a good way. High chest in our language.
We are registered.
I'll close the door. Yeah.
Oh, great.
Over to you guys.
My name is Minah Lee. I'm the one of the hub of the founding members of Art Action Earwig and Wryly.
The other half of the founding members of Art Action Earwig.
We actually came to Saysutshun to meet Dave a few weeks ago to learn more about Saysutshun, the history and ecology, and also many stories, Snuneymuxw stories, and we're very grateful for that. And much of the things we are sharing with you today actually is a conversation, in our own creative conversation with those knowledge we learned, we were gifted with. So, grateful to be here. And thank you again, Haichika, Dave and Snuneymuxw. And of course, thank you so much, Nanaimo Art Gallery. We're going to move to the next site, which is not far from here. And we learned a lot about this place from Dave. So we're going to, do you see there's a like pile of stones over there?
Yeah.
So we're gonna go closer and then find one of the Gary Oak tree together under.
I come from Pstz’uminus First Nation in Penelakut Island, and I moved from the res to the big city in 2000. My traditional name is Kualapathit, and I share that with my dad. My family belongs to the Swaihui. We belong to the mask, and the ladies would call that the stalmi. So the ladies sing and the men dance the mask. And I also belong to the Shawmoses, or not the Shawmoses, the Wahtatin. And my dad sings for the people and the memorials for our people in the longhouse. There's certain families that can do these things. So that's what I belong to. My family's been in Snuneymuxw for a long time. My late grandmother, Madeline Aleck, was married to George Seward Sr. for many years. I just actually lost her about a month ago. But she lived a good life. My Gram, I called her Gram. You know, when I first started to do drum circles, so my name's Patrick Aleck, and if you ever see that in a drum circle, don't be afraid to bring your drum, because I teach you about the drum, what I know. There's different teachings for the drum, you know, but mine came from many elders and my dad. You know, he said, whatever animal that gave its life for you to have the drum, this one, I think this one's elk. And even the sinew, even the cedar gave its life for you to, it's alive still, right? You know, I keep it alive. You can sing along, right? I'll share my medicine with you. And it's not Buckley's either, you know? I can't share that with you. They didn't have London drugs back in the day. We had to go to all the trees Dave was talking about. Didn't have thrifties. Had to look for hoppin' the deer. We want to know you. We don't want to know your occupation or your role. We want to know you. Why are you here? You know, why are you on Saysutshun Island? If you don't know the true history of Canada, I encourage you to get to know the true history and challenge yourself, because it's uncomfortable, the truth of Canadian history. I'm not going to get into it, because you have to do your work, because I've done my work, and I'm continuing to do my work. Hi-yo! Hi-yo! Oh, yeah.
I have one important rule for that song. If you're going to sing it, you have to acknowledge it's mine. Patrick Allen.
We want you to hike the Gary Oak, offering us really beautiful shade, and there's a beautiful sound for us together under here. Yeah, and after we heard from Dave about those Gary Oak and Pema's ecology, nurturing one another, we did a little bit of research because they were so pointed out that lots of Pema's here disappeared. So did some research, and Wryly, why do you think there's not many Pema's here today?
Well, partially habitat loss. They like the Gary Oak ecosystem, and it's been massively diminished. Also, Camas was tended by Indigenous people, but because of disruption, that practice has been disrupted.
Yeah, we actually learned that there used to be like a controlled burning, which is the traditional knowledge that's been practiced by stewards, but then. Yeah.
No, we used to do burnings here. Even they said they found some charcoal that had burned, and we used to burn the ground to get rid of the bad weeds. On my family land on the reserve, we haven't done it this year, but a few years ago we did some burning to remove the bad weeds, and that's the tradition that here goes back thousands of years also. Mm-hmm. And that would allow that camas to come back, we say, in a good way.
Great. So probably discontinued those cultural practices, contributing to the disappearance of them. So we want you to think about the loss and also healing, because those are the big themes we are talking about today. Let's try to connect to Mother Earth underneath a little bit, whatever way that helps. Let's try to travel a little bit to the recent memories of Mother Earth. It's a little bit darker, but again, if it helps you, you can close your eyes, just try to root yourself deeper to the ground, and we are going to go into a little bit of history here. So in recent histories, there have been a lot of extractions happened on this land. Logging, mining, sandstones, and coal mining as well. A lot of things taken from Mother Earth.
It's darker in a deep tunnel. Her elements buried over millions of years. Transforming matter and spirits can easily overwhelm our human lungs and hearts. Colonization, industrialization, Americanization. New modes of survival and desires started exploding with new inventions of technology. We dug deeper to pierce her veins and muscles. We carried her blood and cells. We knew she has lots of wisdom buried in her. We wanted to run faster and learn faster, faster than ever and faster than anyone else. We were so afraid that we are only here for a moment, in this body, in this mind. We got impatient, so we started stealing from her. Without permission, we wanted to possess her wisdom. We quickly carried them away and swiftly burned and burned and burned her wisdom soup. Lots of workers were thrown into the cauldron. Millions of years of spirits from vegetation that had been formed into rock got upset. The spirits were suddenly released into our atmosphere. Without rituals, without respect, without offerings. While we were quickly burning years of her past that we could not grasp with our human time, we didn't feel our future burning. because we were too drunk on the ikjast. However, the spirits witnessed us, our lungs, our hearts, and relationships. How do we console when our relationship is broken?
Thank you for taking this journey with us. Thank you. We want to share a little song with you. And this song came to us a few years back when we just came back from our trip to South Korea, which is our distant home. And yeah, it was also at around time I landed in so-called Canada. Which means that I obtained my permanent residency in Canada. And after so many years of not having residency rights, so during that time, I couldn't really easily go back and visit my home because just all my mental and physical and also financial focus was directed to just my effort to stay in this place and or so often struggles to stay. But when I landed, I suddenly got lots more privilege to this capacity to be able to visit home again. And yeah, this experience helped us to think more deeply about our own privileges. And you guys, what it means, what does it mean to land on stolen land? So just lots of thinkings about what it means to be here and what our responsibilities are.
My carbon body, carbon breath, my carbon reach, carbon death, carbon footprints, sooty bootsteps, carbon touch, carbon taste, my carbon love, carbon waste, carbon footprints, sooty bootsteps, dream to travel. But my footprints write out my desire on the air. Oh, oh, oh.
To be free. China. We learned the wisdom soon, older than millions of years. I want to birth something new that was always in me.
Stories came to us when a pair of extracted molars, wisdom teeth, started speaking, and their names are Mom and Ma. Wisdom teeth is called Wryly. What is it called?
Sarangni.
Sarangni in Korean language, and this means love teeth. Love teeth. So, yeah, in Korean language. And yeah, we actually brought copies of them, Mom and Mom. and they are actually soap teeth as well. So, what are they made of, Kelly, Mom and Mom?
They're made of sesame oil, rice bran oil, olive oil, coconut oil, and cocoa butter.
Yes, it sounds delicious, but don't eat it. It's still soap. But you can wash with them and just take one. And there's Mom and Mom. They are molded out of actual extracted wisdom teeth.
So that's cool.
Teeth. Yeah. And guess who's Mom and who's Mom? We'll...
That's cool.
You're really so cute.
Yeah, I know.
So cute. Wryly, what does mom mean?
Mom means body in Korean.
Yeah, and mom means mind or spirit in Korean language. So, yeah, guess who that is, mom or mom? Guess who we are?
Mom.
You recognize?
Mom.
Oh, who are you?
I'm Mom.
I'm Mom.
And we are
Love Team.
We used to be part of somebody.
That woman.
That woman was concerned that we would cause trouble after her dental coverage expires.
So, she decided to extract us.
Our ancestors used to be much more useful, grinding up hard grains, chewing tough vegetation, even tearing raw meat.
Wow, when was that?
Oh, well, before the widespread rise of agriculture, maybe 12,000 years ago?
Well, now we are rather treated as useless, so we are here, out in the wide open world.
Wow. Surprise! We're talking molars!
Talking molars! Speaking English! How useful is that?
Oh, that's very useful. And we acknowledge our privilege. Nod, nod, nod.
Well, speaking of privilege, we wanted to use our own privileges to share our stories with you.
And stories about our friends.
Who are they?
Pulpstones.
Ooh, pulpstones. They must have been part of sandstone on this land.
Yes, and they were cut into identical pieces and sent off to work.
Identical pieces? Whoa. What kind of work?
Well, they were sent to pulp mills all across North America, where they grind up, cut down trees, and revolve at more than 200 times per minute.
What? That's hard work! Well, what are they doing here now?
Well, now they're useless.
Useless? Well, like wisdom teeth? Like you and I?
We are love teeth.
Well, in Korean language. Well, so, how did pulp stones become useless?
Well, humans invented more efficient technology.
Technology. So they were abandoned.
Yes, but they still speak to history.
History. Well, what are those piles of pulp stones doing over there?
Those pulp stones? Those pulp stones are blocking the underground tunnels that run under the harbor. They were used to carry coal from the island.
Coal carried through veins of Mother Earth. To be
burnt and burnt.
And now so many forests are burning and burning and burning and burning. That's a lot.
It's an ongoing consequence of mass extraction.
Extraction! That was a big moment in our lives, remember?
When we were extracted, we thought we would be broken into pieces and thrown into the medical garbage.
However,
we were released like baby teeth. Being free is not easy. When the anesthesia wore off, a part of that woman that had been numbed slowly blossomed out from the pits that we had been rooted in.
The hole seemed so deep and piercing that she felt connected.
To what?
To her inner self.
Once, she pierced her belly button.
So she can take care of the wound.
That carries her back to the umbilical cord.
That was lost. How long does it take?
To heal?
When we lose?
When we are lost.
We're going to move to our next site, and we're going to take it slow.
So the spot here is called a sacred spirit portal. Does anyone know what a spirit portal is? A spirit portal is where we can connect sometimes with the spirit realm in a good way.
When Dave's talking about, you know, a portal, that connection, the spirit, that connection between two worlds, too, like the spirit world and the physical world, you know, it's not too far away, that's the teaching. Some believe it's the sky, but we believe it's not too far. They can come visit at any time, our relatives, right? So, and when you see, when you have a vision, it's a gift when they show themselves. Even in dreams, if you have dreams of loved ones that passed on, that's a gift. Don't get too hurt when you have those dreams. Enjoy those tears, and, you know, that's the love. You know, thank you for visiting. Thank you, I've been missing you. But they do that sometimes to check on you too. I'm gonna sing another song for you. Ait shqualuin hualmuch mistimuch. Good feelings to all the people. Because my friend, I told her to delegate me today. I don't want to make decisions. Just tell me what to do. And I'm not always like that. I'm rebellious and I go against the waves. You know, and what do you do when you go against the waves? You get hit, you know? So I said, let's paddle together and see what we could do. So, Ait shqualuin hualmuch mistimuch. Can you say the whole thing? Ait shqualuin hualmuch mistimuch. Good feelings from your mind, heart, and spirit. That's what it means. Ait shqualuin. And the hualmuch mistimuch is to all my people, but I equate it to everybody. I'm spreading good feelings to you. And the drummers just follow along. Mess up if you want to.
Memories of them.
Sensations of them.
And fears of them.
How do we learn to live with them?
Or let them go. Or...
or let them be.
So they become.
That woman. My Japanese friend told me that wisdom tooth in Japanese language means unknown to parents. If there's a tooth called unknown to a child, it'll be my father's tombstone, rooted somewhere in the soft gum of Mother Earth. Every day, it's wearing the sun, rain, and wind, and in turn, is worn by them. They wear each other much slower than flesh. That tooth looks ageless. I never ventured to find that tooth, even if I were to accidentally see it, and feel that this whole world shares only one roof, I won't recognize it. His first language was Japanese, though it was not his mother tongue. A Korean born in Japan during the Imperial Japanese occupation of Korea, his figure to me is like a poorly preserved historical painting. It's too blurry to see and too delicate to touch. With my humble human head, I can picture abstract imagery of his Japanese name engraved on the tooth. A name of someone who was not welcomed by nation-state, but wide welcomed by Mother Earth. Unknown to a child. Therefore, I can't forget it. It is somewhere, and sometime beyond my flesh time, so I won't lose it. I'm okay to leave it at that.
Kachia, kachia, honey, chupe, say it
being here. Hi, Chupka. Hi, Chupka.